Hello everyone and welcome back to the Dutch Petting Zoo. And as you probably expected, I'm joined again by Jure.
Hello!
Hello. And what are we doing today? Well, I had no clue what to add, and then I went through the comments on your previous video.
Oh, you stole from my comments. Yeah.
Yes, of course. But it was a comment by one of my moderators, so I thought, yeah, I can use that. And they told us, well, we are missing something, which is a Dutch windmill.
And a ferry too.
And a ferry, yeah, but that's going to be the next episode. So in this episode, we are going to add a windmill. Beautiful little structure that I'm trying to create here. It's a horrible shape to try to make.
Yeah, I'm really interested in how you're making this, because ships like these are a pain to make.
I struggled for like 2 hours, and then I finally found out how to make it. And then I'm using again these octagonal things, the roofs. So that will be the bottom shape. And then I'm adding these nice little planks, and I'm moving them around. And then in the end, it's working fine. I'm using these recolorable things so where people can use it as well. I will put it on the workshop in the end. So you can make a green windmill or a yellow one. Whatever you want.
An orange one. Gorgeous.
An orange one. Yeah. Or a blue one.
Yeah.
Whatever you want.
A brown one.
Yeah. That's what we are doing today. So that's that's quite interesting. I was thinking about recreating like Kinderdijk. So that's the place in the Netherlands with like 100
windmills. All the tourists.
Windmills. Yeah. Yeah. With all the... Yeah. Exactly. All the tourists. And
I've never been there. Dutch.
No, I've been there once. Okay. It's not that interesting if you're
just windmills.
If you're Dutch, you can.
There's one in my street.
Yeah, exactly. No, yeah, there was one like right next to my supermarket in the place that I used to live. So it's not that interesting for us, but it's probably very interesting for a lot of tourists. And it's also interesting to make it in the game. So I'm almost finished with this this first wall. I'm trying to make some nice wooden trims. Then I'm copying it to the other side. I make sure I have still the the frame that I made. And then, it doesn't fit. So I have to redo it.
It does fit.
It doesn't fit on the bottom.
Well, so you just
make it a little bit wider on the bottom.
Ah.
And then I will redo it. I wanted to include all the struggles that I had in this, this
Fair
video.
Enough. Yeah.
So I will also redo the entire trim thing. To make it look a little bit nicer, because I'm copying it and then it's like overlapping and I don't like that, and like clipping and stuff like that. It was a nice little struggle, to be honest. And you were making like ferries and you're gonna make a ferry and what was the other thing?
Greenhouse.
Like a freight ship.
Oh.
And you're gonna add a greenhouse. So I thought I have to do something with like a shitload of pieces that like doesn't contribute anything to the zoo. And I thought, I have to do that as well to make some nice little props. And you can see it fits a little bit better now, but the trims are not really working. So I remove that one and I make another one. So the windmill is still looking a little bit white, which is weird, of course, but we will fix that. You can see this trim is looking a little bit better, and I will make sure it fits. And then, see, that's much better.
Nice.
And I will copy that.
Clean.
All over the place, of course. I really stared at like all the windmill pictures that I could find in on the Google.
Sounds like a pain.
Yeah, it was. It was. I was really happy when it was finished, to be honest. And it worked out really well. So this is the basic shape. I'm really happy with that. Trying to find a nice color. This is a little bit too dark in my opinion, so I changed that later. And then I'm starting on the bottom, but the bottom is yet again not like a 4 meter wall piece, so I had to do something with that. And again, these painted bricks that we are using all over the place.
Oh yeah.
And I decided to go for a little white bottom here. I had a big struggle also with the like the 3D gizmo thing. Every time I tried to copy something, it didn't fit. You could a few seconds ago you did see that.
Oh, wait, with the rotation or?
Yeah, with the rotation.
Yeah,
it's gonna be a pain. But you will see that later on as well with like these things that rotate. What do you call them in English? I don't know. I should have
wheels.
Wheels. I should have done some research. And then another horrible piece of the windmill is the top. I'm using these East Asian things to create like a nice little shape. So this will be the part that the wheels are connected to, to the front.
I don't think they're actually called wheels. I thought
what are they called?
I don't know. We call them weekend, right?
Weekend, yes. We call them weeks
I'm
now.
I'm going to Google that actually while we're doing this.
Yeah, it's good. That's a good thing. So I'm making them a little bit green and then some other colors to make it look a little bit more interesting. So while Jurre is Googling...
Windmill blades.
Windmill ding, blades. Ding, ding. Oh, blades, of course. Yeah,
yeah, blades. There you go.
So I'm removing some pieces over there. Some things that we didn't need. And so this is quite an interesting shape. You will if you Google like these windmills, it's impossible to make in the game. So I made it a little bit different from what it actually is. Normally it's like these like the stuff that we don't have in the game, like the roofs that you were struggling with the last time. It's like the wheat stuff.
Well, props to you for making this mill. Like it's not an easy project at all. It's very hard to do for what it looks like. And it looks great. Yeah. Like, I've never seen such a great windmill in either Planet Zoo or Planet Ghost because a lot of people have made it there too. So, I'm really happy with how you're making this.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I'm actually using some of the Australia pieces as well. I thought, we have to do something with that with the new DLC.
Yeah.
So these metal things. I will use them for the blades. I think it's called blades.
Wait, that's
now
metal?
I'm thinking about it. Yeah, the windmill. I'm still struggling with that windmill blades. I don't know. We should have looked it up before we started recording this. So I'm using all these like little small windmill pieces or wooden pieces to make these nice little blades. Of course, it's like over 4,000 pieces, I think, this entire build. And as you can see, I tried to copy it and that didn't work.
No,
so
yes,
I have to do them all manually. It's kind of a long video like this, but it's kind of an interesting shape in the end. I try to make it look as realistic as possible. Normally they would add some plastic stuff so the wind could actually force that thing to turn around.
Oh yeah,
but I will use some wooden pieces for that. I'm trying to copy it, and then of course that doesn't work. You can see, oh wow, how does he do that? you can really see like a 15-minute struggle here with with me trying to copy this around, but then later
on
I will.
So much PTSD.
this is horrible. Yeah, I just wanted to add this in the video. I could have cut that out, but
that's
anyway.
Right.
These nice little white trims, I will make them green, and then on the back I will add some white stuff as well, just to make it look a little bit more interesting. And they're realistic as well. Right now I'm trying something else. I had an idea. So what I'm doing now is I'm making small grass, and then I'm adding another plank later on. But I will use these mudstone things, which have a grid, which is perfect.
Ah,
now
classic.
You can line up the grid, and then you can copy it. See, that works. So if anyone. Ever struggling with that, you can use these pieces. I didn't know why I didn't do that like in the first time, but I don't know. I probably needed some sleep or something. Some nice little rope pieces. And then we do the same thing again with this beautiful mudstone thing. Copy it, and there you go. Beautiful, connects perfectly. We remove the other one. And then some nice little effects that I'm adding here. See, it can
actually
turn around. Yeah, that was kind of nice. You can see, I just wanted to make sure that it doesn't hit the bottom or something like that. Another piece of the Australia pack. I just had to do something with that. And then these wooden beams on the back. I'm not sure about that, but I think people can actually use it to line up the windmill itself.
Doesn't the house rotate? No,
yeah,
it doesn't,
a bit.
Right? Yeah?
I'm not sure. But one thing I did know is that it has like a break. I actually Googled it, and I will add that later on.
Okay.
But I think you can use this one to align the windmill itself. I'm not sure. Maybe someone's watching And it's like, okay, I'm a windmill expert and I can tell you guys.
It's completely wrong! What are you doing? Destroying my heritage?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. These nice little wooden beams on the back. Yeah, it's just a lot of watching like reference images for this one. But yeah, people will make a picture of a windmill and usually make a picture of the front and not from the back.
Yeah.
So that was kind of a struggle to finally find it. And there is actually one kind of windmill thing on the workshop. So I take a look at that. I will be honest with that. But I did give it my own little twist, of course. So this is like wooden beam thingy. This is actually a brake. So there's a rope going down and people can pull it. Oh. And then I think it will stop turning or something.
Okay.
I don't know. But I will use it as an enrichment item later on. You will see that. Because we're also adding an animal. Yeah.
That's
a bit of a surprise in the end of the video. So these nice little windows, you have to put that in. It's,
look at this man using all these wooden planks. Sorry.
All over the place. Beautiful. And it makes it look kind of realistic, I think. I was actually quite happy. I didn't know how to do this, but it works. So I was happy with that. Nice, another little wooden beam, little plank. Beautiful. We add a door, we add some windows here.
Ooh.
I've made these windows in the very first episode, I think. So I'm using them again. Beautiful. You can see another window.
People have to duck when they leave the house.
yeah, but it's actually like this.
Oh, yeah.
So I found the images and like the door is like exactly like right next to these blades. So yeah, I don't know if you will get.
Yeah.
I think there's also a Dutch saying like that you got hit by one of these things and that you got a little mad or something.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Okay.
So I put it like on a random place on the map. I thought usually these windmills are right next to the water. So I also put it right next to the water. I created a nice little bridge here. The staff can't use it. No, nobody can use it, but it's just another prop that is completely useless, but looks fine. And,
that's what we're here for, yeah.
Yeah. Another thing I found, I think this machine thing also needs water. So it has to...
Isn't it... Like, doesn't windmills like pump water out of areas to make more fields?
Well, that should be... maybe that is the thing that I'm using. Or like
I think you have
right
like
now.
Grain mills and like water mills. I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, so the things that I found were probably water mills.
Yeah, okay.
And they always are like connected to the water and have like something like this with concrete and probably the place that where it pumps the water. And then... making a nice color, and then I'm trying to blend it in with like the terrain and stuff like that. The beautiful fence that I already created. I like to reuse stuff, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Like the fence I already made. Make it a nice little area. And then when I finished this one, I was like, yeah, I didn't add any animal, and I don't want to be like Jure that is only.
Oh.
And adding a useless prop to the zoo, and I want to add.
Okay.
Like it's called the Dutch Petting Zoo.
I see how it is.
Yeah, it's called the petting zoo, so we have to have some animals that we can actually pet. So I'm adding some dogs in the end. I had this image like in front of me that was like the owner of the windmill has a dog and the dog is lying.
It's a dingo
down at the front. Yeah. And it's a dingo, yeah. That was kind of a spoiler. there's an entire story.
What other animal do we have as a dog?
Yeah, yeah. I was thinking like the African wild dog, but that looked weird. But that's why they added the dingo. They wanted to please us with like a petting zoo animal. So I'm adding the dingoes to this
nice,
area.
Nice.
You can't really see it, but I put like fencing all around the place. I did cut that out. In the video, because it was a struggle with like the transversible area, because these like dogs can swim and jump like everywhere. I'm putting it on a bench, by the way. Like if you put down a single piece of path and then put down a bench,
and delete it,
and you remove the path again.
Yeah.
Oh, some lighting! Oh, beautiful.
Wow.
I will another light. Oh, and it's daylight again. So a lot of elephant grass and other stuff, and a lot of trees, and I'm just trying to finish up this area, and of course nothing is like completely flat, so a bit of terrain work, some grass, some props that we used everywhere. Oh, another Australia pack piece. Wow, beautiful. Wow. And a wheel thing and a bucket. Yeah,
very authentic. Yeah,
yeah, beautiful. See,
wow,
it all comes together now.
It does really look nice. A really good job. For some pellets.
Yeah, I like the pellets in the new pack.
Yeah, I have actually had teamed blueprints of pellets made by Mr. Domas, but now we have them in game. I think they actually saw that and thought like, oh, let's make it. Like, set it to the game.
Oh, see, I'm making a rich.
Oh, yeah, that's fun.
Yeah, so this is where the dogs can lie down and have a drink and have some food and some chewing things. And you can see I placed the fence all around the place.
Oh, yeah.
But they can jump all over it and yeah, it was fun. You can see I will check the transversible area. Only a few places where they can escape. But that's all fixed. It took me 2 hours and there was like 10 seconds in the video. Oh.
Ooh, oh, that's really good. Oh my god. That looks so good.
Beautiful. I'm really happy with it.
Yeah, you should be. You should add this on the workshop.
I will. There will be a link down in the description to the workshop, so everyone can use it in their Dutch zoo, of course. And now we will just enjoy the beautiful cinematics. And I hope you guys enjoyed this one. And if you did, make sure you hit the like button. And if you didn't do it already, make sure you subscribe to our channels. There will be a link down in the description to Jurgen's channel as well. And the next episode will be on his channel. So we will speak to you guys in the next one. Goodbye.
Bye.